Good. We'll start seated, just with one leg crossed in front of the other. Maybe a blanket underneath your sit bones, maybe not. We'll take a little bit of a mindful moment here before we move into our first pose. Maximize on our time to spend together while we journey within. This is another practice I'm going to offer tonight, where I'm holding space and time and calling out poses and transitions, but largely remaining silent to offer plenty of time to dive within to your meditation practice, noticing your breath. All of you have a very well-established practice. So that's how we're going to move through our practice tonight. Taking three intentional breaths together, drawing in through the nose and out. Again, breathing in and out. One more breath together, in, sigh out. Letting your body become soft and heavy with each exhale. Returning back to a natural rhythm that suits your need. So we're arriving here in this moment, reaching out with your senses into this space, or into your space. Noticing the temperature of the air, vibration, and energy. Your breath guiding your attention and awareness to the space of your heart and noticing how your heart feels today. No wrong answer, expectation, or judgment. Asking yourself how your heart feels. Consider your emotional body, your spiritual body. Consider for a moment your physical body. Starting at the crown of your head, moving your energy and awareness down the spine towards the tips of your toes. So notice what you're feeling, what you're carrying with you tonight. Inviting a small portion of that energy that doesn't serve you either in this hour or your day beyond, letting it fall away for the moment or for the greater good of your highest friends. Take another deep breath here. Nice complete release, starting to hinge forward wherever you are, just walking into a little bit of a forward fold with your legs crossed. We're changing the shape of our body after having sat bolt upright more or less for about 6 to 7 minutes. breathing yourself up and away from that. And maybe hands come out and around slowly behind your seat. Lean back, take a few seated windshield wipers. The first pose that we're going to spend some time in is going to be a child's pose. We're going to begin from the tabletop shape of our bodies for our first few poses. Because I know I typically will guide the class in a different direction, so we'll change it up. You feel good after a windshield wiper, you can start to make your way around nice and slow towards a child's pose. You can use bolster or not, it's up to you. Release choice.
I am.
more breaths here. We're going to offer to use the rebound, the feeling that we have in our hips and our low back as we move into our next pose, which will be a Sphinx pose. If you prefer to take other movements in stillness for your counter pose instead of going right to the Sphinx, that's always available. The whole reason I'm cueing it that way is because as you stretch out your legs behind you and you get into the back bend of the Sphinx pose, you really have an opportunity to notice what you're feeling in your body from your navel down to your knees. Scanning just in that manner or any manner you prefer, there's all that sensation there to keep you grounded. Take three more breaths here in this very passive back bend. Counter pose here will be going down all the way to the front body, crocodile pose. Very slowly starting to lower down, coming off of elbows. If you prefer not to lie all the way face down, please substitute any body position that works for you. Breathe your awareness and attention to the sacral spine, low back, hips. From navel to knees, just notice what you're feeling. Thank you. are here in this place of stillness. We offer some time spent in a broken wing. Wing pose. I will start with my right arm going straight out. Yogi's choice to put whatever arm out you'd like first, and then just rolling into the shoulder. A little bit of shoulder opening here. Breathing into those spaces in your body where you feel resistance to gravity. Two more breaths here. Softly breathing ourselves back around onto your belly. I like to just take a brief Sphinx pose here as a change of shape to my body. Counter pose, you can use anything in your wheelhouse that you prefer. Just lying in crocodile pose. Slowly starting to move your way over to the opposite side. Keeping in mind that if kickstanding a leg is not comfortable for you, you can always just stack hips, bend your knees with stacked hips, and you'll still get some stretch in your shoulder. Thank you. two breaths here. And slowly starting to roll back around onto the belly. Maybe taking that brief sphinx pose, maybe just moving up in the direction of a tabletop shape. You can take some cat-cows here if you would like. Or any sort of intuitive, independent movement. Remain in our tabletop shape for one more round of poses on either side of the body. Then I'll be spending some time in swan or sleeping swan. Let's start with either leg. I always begin with the left. Another few breaths of our movement or stillness. I'm going to cue and offer to keep this swan pretty gentle, just starting in tabletop shape as opposed to three-legged dog. Just inviting knee to wrist and stepping extended leg back. Alternative for this pose, a four square. I like to remain upright for the first few breaths and then lowering down, maybe even over a bolster. In this pose for a number of minutes, so just make sure you're comfortable either way. Thank you. awareness and breath back into our body. Take 2 to 3 more breaths here. Start to press into the mat, softly lifting up, moving into any countering shape. I usually choose a hero's pose or low kneeling or anything, even sitting on your seat. Just box the hips off for a moment. And then the ultimate counter pose would be going to the opposite side. Have a rebound sensation on the opposite side. There's no rush. Take your time. Take some cat cow. Go right into the pose. First few breaths for the first minute, just noticing the difference. The sensation building on one side and fading in the other. Take two or three more breaths here. Slowly starting to move yourself up and away. Maybe drawing the full leg back to meet the opposite knee. Even pressing out legs one at a time. Straightening them behind you, you can feel nicer. Looking for anything, any intuitive movements, posture. To meeting a low kneeling offer of toe squat. Definitely important to have, well, if you can, anyway, tuck all pinky toes under, all 10 toes. Three more breaths and we'll call it good. Encourage you to work on your toe squat in your home practice. That time for our caterpillar pose. I'm going to cue this kind of like we did last year when I without props, but I encourage you to use props. Since I'm cueing it without props, it won't be, it'll probably be about a 3 minute hold. If that is any determining factor for your props. Nice and relaxed from your waist down to your toes. Inhale, sweeping arms up. Exhale, reaching up out of your hips. Reaching forward, keeping your heart lifted, chin parallel with the floor. And then relaxing everything. It doesn't matter how low you go. It matters how you keep your back straight and you're hinging at your hips. And then soften. Tips of toes, all up and back down to the tips of your fingers. Trying to soften everything. down in a less active manner and just see where you land there without judgment. Like, cue this active manner, how we got into the posture initially, just because it's more sensation driven instead of just putting a bunch of pillows in front of our forehead and tipping over. You invest some breath and energy into it. Reversing the order in which you fold it forward, very slowly tipping up your heart and your back into a straight and neutral position as early as possible, and just bringing hands back, and let's take some seated bench. Or if you like to just sit in stillness, you can do that also. Our next pose will be a seated butterfly with a forward fold. Thank you. two more breaths, right as we are. Slowly start to lift yourself up and away if you're ready. Stepping legs out in the direction of straight, leaning back into our modified reverse plank, or rocking side to side. So we'll be lowering down to our backs. We're going to have two poses before our time in Shavasana. What you're going to do is supported bridge and then into a happy baby for actually a minute or two. And then into Shavasana. So lower down however you'd like. And slowly arriving. Before you worry about putting a block to your sacrum, inviting your knees in towards the body, perhaps one at a time. Let's take some side to side walk. So we're just arriving onto our back body and our breath. Inviting the soles of the feet back down onto the ground, reaching for our block. You can continue rocking if you would like to, or you can go ahead and set yourself up in this supported bridge. Making sure you're comfortable. Sacrum is supported. Step your legs out in the direction of straight, one at a time or at the same time. inviting two more breaths, nice and deep into your belly. Up and removing the block, slowly lowering your hips down to your mat. I like to almost right away offer to invite knees into chest. Just hold that in stillness for a moment. You're going to notice still additional sensation and rebound. Space of your hips. Side to side, windshield wipers. You're yearning for some movement before we take a happy baby for about 2 minutes. So a couple options with the happy baby is taking a super modified Yinster version, which is just inviting knees in. You can even hook ankles if you like. You can also reach for big toes or outsides of the feet. Keeping the sacrum rooted, not the tailbone, even rocking side to side. Taking two more breaths intentionally. Returning soles of the feet to the mat. Starting to make your way to your favorite shape for your shavasana, whether that's seated or reclining on your back. Sacred space, dedicated time of rest. Noticing what you're feeling in your body, without judgment, only love. Thank you. Softly inviting some awareness back into the space of your body. Into this space that we've held for one another. I'd like for you to remain as you are for the sealing of our practice. And we'll take one more breath all together in through the nose. Sigh out. May the longtime sun shine upon you. All love surround you, and the pure light that is within you guide your way. Namaste. Rush. Keep all the time you need.